Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Astrological Intentions. I am your host, bringing the stars down to you, Alex Reavy, as well as the doggy Donatella herself, Sandy Reavy. Say hi.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
We'll explain why soon. So this is episode 80, and it is February 3rd here in the Jazz Fuzz studio. Let's get right into it. We have, in the transits, February 3rd, Mercury ingress Pisces.
In his detriment and shadow.
Same day, Venus sextile Saturn.
Love plus reality.
Wednesday, February 5th, Mercury sextile Uranus.
Sudden insights.
Friday, February 7th, Venus ingress Aries.
Outgoing and social and a little bit fickle.
Then Sunday, February 9th, the full moon in Leo.
Stepping up your game to shine.
Then some talisman times that Sandy has finished up to heal illness, as well as two very special upcoming to speak the truth and to incorporate global togetherness. Then on the horizon, we are going live with Dr. Laura Berman on her radio show in the studio in Los Angeles. So check in with us on the horizon. We have LA, online, Elk Grove, online again, some North Lake, as well as all the way to Bali, Indonesia. Then in our house, Sandy and I are going to talk about our doggy Donatella moments with our favorite little Maltese, Kila. So stay tuned for this episode of Astrological Intentions.
You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys. You got the keys.
I can't believe it's episode 80.
I know. Let's go. I'm excited. It's been fun.
Absolutely. And of course, from the top of every episode, I love to go direct to you all. However, I'm going to hold those for right now and for next week because we have a special guest on the line with us. We have Susan Gidel. You know her from Chatting with the Stars. It's a Sandy-Susan duo that come together. They babble along talking about astrology and how it pertains to you. And so, Susan, welcome so much to the show.
Hi, Alex. Hi, Sandy. Nice to be here.
Yeah, we're here so that we can do a little introduction of our new Chatting with the Stars webinars.
Woo-hoo! And so I think this really started out with all of you guys kind of like just getting asked so many times, do you teach? Will you teach more? Mm-hmm. And we really started Chatting with the Stars as one-on-one readings, and that was how many years ago?
At least five.
Yeah, five or six, maybe.
I'm going to say five. Yeah, maybe six. Yeah. Where we just, you and I would look at someone's chart for whether it was a half hour sign up or an hour sign up, and they'd have a question and we'd answer it. And
yeah. We were still kind of getting our sea legs then in terms yeah. of reading charts. And so it was really great experience all the way around. And
right.
we had a lot and of fun, and the people we read for had a lot of fun.
Yeah, and it was just you and I kind of meshing, too, both of our skills of how we come at a chart.
Exactly.
And, you know, yeah. it's kind of, you know, evolved into this. Then we kind of followed Barbara Shermer's cosmic trends that we would run every quarter. And then we started doing those online.
And that's been a really successful, you know, thing that we've created. We, every single quarter, you and Susan come together on Facebook and Instagram. Mm-hmm. You go live, which I'm sure, you know, at first I remember you guys being a little bit nervous about that. But now...
Oh, yeah.
I don't even know. How many years has it been? Like 3 or 4 years, and you guys have it down. Like you're just ready to go.
Right. There's no rehearsal anymore.
Oh, right,
no.
Of course.
Oh, no.
And so tell me a little bit about the astrology webinars. Susan, what are you most excited to...
Well, let's follow the line here. So,
oh, sure.
You know, we're doing the quarters, and we do our you know, once a month in the evening from, it's like from 7 to 9 p.m. the second Wednesday of of every month. And Susan and I get together and, you know, we do half hour reading. So that's been now through internet, right? And phone calls. So that's what we've been doing. We stopped doing the one-on-ones in person. And so now at the end of 2019, it was like, we're ready for the next step, right?
Yeah. And so introducing Chatting with the Stars webinars. The same night as we do our Chatting with the Stars readings, the second Wednesday of every month. Mm-hmm. An hour-long teaching, learning webinar ahead of that from 5:30 to 6:30 mm-hmm. Central, where we'll be on a Zoom call mm-hmm. with everyone and talk a little bit about what is going on currently in the sky that can affect everyone. And our mm-hmm. first one is about Mercury retrograde.
Right. It's a really important topic to talk about because a lot of first entries into astrology. When people learn mm-hmm. about what is Mercury retrograde, it's almost this rite of passage. So once you know what people are talking about when they talk about Mercury retrograde, there you go. And so what a wonderful first step to start with these webinar series.
Mm-hmm. And the fact that it has, that's what's going on in the month of February.
Right. So you're keeping everything very current. Mm-hmm. And so, Susan, I want to hear a little bit from you. What are you most excited about these webinars?
I think I'm most excited about being able to work with Sandy and have our fun back and forth conversation to bring our personality mm-hmm. into how to learn astrology. You know, I think we have a good mm-hmm. vibe that comes really naturally just because we're good friends and even though we're Pisces and Capricorn, that seems to work somehow. And
well, it is a sextile.
And I am older, so that works out okay.
Yes, by 2 months. Yeah.
So I think the fun that we have in our quarterly outlooks and in our regular readings, I think will come through as a new way to learn astrology. You don't have to read a book. You don't have to go to a boring YouTube video that's just one way. There'll be both of us talking about it, both of us bringing our experience and insight into it. And we have different thoughts about almost everything that we see. Mm-hmm. You know, we have different viewpoints that are we talk about. Mm-hmm. And so I think it'll be a new way to learn.
I agree. And I'm excited because, you know, as we do this, we're going to try to keep it to 60 minutes each one of these webinars. But we're doing a little bit of the add-ons, and the add-on on the front end of the add-on would be this extra small little cost for you to get your personal chart by giving me your birth information. I'll create your birth chart with whatever the situation is. That first webinar would be with Mercury in Pisces retrograde on your chart, so that it'll be a bi-wheel, so you'll be able to follow through during the webinar when Susan and I are saying, hey, if you have any planets between, you know, 28 degrees of this and 5 degrees of that, you'll be able to look onto your own personal chart and see yes or no. So it'll help with learning your own chart.
And so what other additions are you adding to the webinars too?
You want to tell them, Susan?
We really would like to extend our own personal connection with any of these transits in each webinar, our personal experience with them through life. So you get to know a little bit more about us and about how things work in mm-hmm. real life and the experience that we've had with them. Which is right. Honestly the best way to learn astrology is to study your own chart.
Right. And the other bonus, though, that I was referring to is the fact that anyone can come in after the webinar, about an hour later. We're set up for 15-minute increments of anything that was taught in the webinar that now can get related directly to that client's chart.
Right.
You know, that attended the class. So for a small little extra fee, but that I think is another way for a student or a hobbyist of astrology, because I agree with you that the best way to learn astrology is through your own chart. It really is. And so we can help you with that, with both learning and then applying to your chart.
Yeah. And so I also want to really drive in the fact that these webinars are at an unprecedented price, because they're $20. Yeah. We're starting these webinars at $20, and that is available for anyone and everyone. We can fit big groups into this as well so that many people can learn and understand astrology. We don't have limited seats here because it's all virtually done. Mm-hmm. And whether or not you're there live in person, we would, of course, prefer you to be there. However, even if you can't make it, we're going to be recording these, and you can purchase even after the webinar is finished. Mm-hmm. And so the one thing that you're going to want to do, though, is be the first sign up, because Sandy and Susan are going to be taking the first sign up and using that chart, using that person's chart as an example. So during this whole webinar, if you are the first person to sign up, you are going to pretty much have your own personal one-on-one understanding of what is happening with this transit in your chart, right? Right.
It's true. Of course, we'll get permission from you, but that that being said, we'll be using your chart that'll be on the screen. Yeah, because there will be a small PowerPoint that sounds really horrible for a Pisces, but it'll be slides, you know, fun slides,
images
that you can,
and pictures ways for you and
drawings
Susan
and videos. And, okay, Alex, that sounds like fun.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, I that's pretty much how I've gotten to know astrology, is from both you, Mom, of course, and Susan. And I do like, one of the things that I value most about chatting with the stars is the two perspectives, because I don't see that anywhere else. Mm-hmm. When I'm, you know, in the presence of a whole lot of other astrologers, like at conferences and other places, they all have this kind of one-on-one format going on. And so I've never really seen this like two-person discussion and also analysis on people's personal charts before. Mm-hmm. So this is, you guys are very unique in that realm. And yeah, I try to tell people that it is very cool, because you get the Piscean mystical,
spiritual, magical side
of astrology, but you also get the practical, foundational, financial, like Susan Gidel style of a chart. So you don't have to go to multiple people to get their perspectives. You need to go to one place and you get both perspectives. You can ask questions to both of them, to one of them, and receive that information that you're looking for.
Beautiful.
It's happened.
That sounds great. Sign me up.
It's happened often, Alex, that when Sandy and I are doing a chatting with the stars reading, she'll say something or I'll say something, and the other one will look at the other and go, "Oh my God, that's right." And so, you know, to have two astrologers say, "Oh my God, yes, that's really it." I think really helps drive home the point that this is really important. And that there's more than just one opinion in agreement about that.
Right, confirmation.
Yeah. Yeah, so exciting. So you sign up with going to intentionbeads.com/events.
Yes, and so you'll see the little...
That first one is the February... So the first one is February 12th at 5:30 to 6:30. That's Central Time. Then our next one... is we're teaching about the spring equinox and Saturn in Aquarius.
And that is March 11th.
That's March 11th. And then April, I'm in Bali, you're in Bali, Alex. So we're going to skip April, and then we'll continue in May, and we'll hold those topics. But if you go to the website right now, are they all up, Alex?
They are all up. You just have to go to intentionbeads.com/events. Susan, would you like to come along with us into the transits when we discuss what's going on this week?
Sure, that'd be fun.
All right, so moving into the transits, we have Monday, February 3rd, Mercury ingress Pisces.
So this happens at 5:37 a.m., and I've titled this In Detriment and In His Shadow. So this is when Mercury moves into Pisces. This is more my style because my Mercury is in Pisces, but it's a very intuitive placement. Good memory is based on retained feelings around a particular situation or meeting someone. So this was kind of interesting for me, and this is going to be my Mercury return month. So things can get a little unclear. The details aren't as clean and crisp because they're kind of in water. So there's a distortion, and you may get your feelings hurt easily by misunderstanding what was meant. Susan, can you comment on what do you think about Mercury moving into Pisces?
Well, you know, I always look at things through a financial lens, and so Mercury rules trading. And so Mercury in Pisces says that your trading decisions, you could start to be really waffling about them, not as crisp and clear and clean and precise as you might normally be. So to just be on alert for getting a little fuzzier and, oh, should I do that? Should I not do that? Will only get exacerbated when Mercury ultimately goes retrograde later in the month. But this is going to be a little preview of what trading is going to be like for most of February and into March.
Well, that's interesting because this is, you know, on this day today, which is everybody's listening to if you got this on Monday, Mercury stays in Pisces for 9 weeks, except for the 1 week it dips backwards into the sign previous, which is that Aquarius. So that's a long time when, you know, Mercury usually stays 3 weeks in a sign. This is 9 weeks. So yeah, that's a good period to, and on this day on the 3rd, he moves into a shadow. So, you know, again, not a real good time to do some of the Mercury retrograde things like, moving forward on a contract or buying a car or, you know, all those things unless you're really, I mean, you can sign, but you have to be very, very clear on what you're signing and what you're agreeing to.
And just be aware that it's not going to come to you like, you know, snap your fingers and you got it. Mm-hmm. It could take a little while to that's what that really means. Oh, that's what that really means.
Mm-hmm. So things become a little bit more clear.
Until they do. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. I mean, it's great for artistic pursuits. You know, it's great.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah. So you don't have to be real clear here. Just know that you're not. That's the key. Be aware of your perception is fuzzy.
Well, so moving on to the next transit, Monday, February 3rd, same day, Venus sextile Saturn.
Right. So that happens at 4:01 this afternoon on Monday. Love plus reality. Because Venus in Pisces, where she is exalted, and it's sextile to Saturn. So it's really about getting clear. Venus wants to get clear from some of that fog. Now, this is more about the heart center, Venus, that feels relationships are in good order. It's a good time to understand and express your love relationships.
And when you say love, I say money. to me, this is getting some Venus sextile Saturn is getting some supportive relationships into the world of money, whether it's a new contract or it's a new partner in a project that you're working on or a new teammate that's coming on board. those will be, pay attention to what comes in that day and maybe the day before and after. Those could be really solid relationships, mm-hmm. that could help propel whatever it is that you want to make happen. Mm-hmm. Saturn is about being long-term, stable, reliable. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, the people that show up on that day are the people to keep your eye on that could be around for a while.
I think it's a great idea, too, because it's happening on the day that Mercury moves into Pisces, right, and goes into his shadow. And then here you're meeting all these people. And it's like, what do you do with that? Do you engage? Yes, you get their contact information. You get their business card. You share yours. You can start conversation here. It doesn't mean you're going to start a conversation and conclude it, agreement task all in the same day. But, you know, you're going to continue the conversation. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, even through maybe the retrograde cycle.
And I'll add that the next day, there's no transits going on in the sky, but it is the midpoint between the winter solstice and the spring equinox. Mm. And it's one of the Gan day. For the trader W.D. Gann from 100 years ago, who was, I consider, the first financial astrologer. And people today still try to figure out what he was doing and how, and put his trading ideas and practices mm-hmm. into place.
Yeah, I've heard you talk about that.
It's 10 a year. The halfway point between each season is one of them. And so Tuesday, February 4 mm-hmm. Is a Gan day. And just look for, in the markets, just for a little change in trend. Okay. Prices could just, you know, do a little reversal.
Well, you know, interesting, because on Wednesday the 5th, we have Mercury sextile Uranus. And that happens at 3:43 mm-hmm. a.m. And I call that sudden insight. So, yeah, these new changes, they're exciting, they're new, they could be brilliant. These are the new ideas, maybe the conversations that of the people that you've met the last few days. It, you know, Mercury in its shadow or even a Mercury retrograde does not mean stop talking. It does not mean to stop communicating. It just, especially right. in the Pisces, it can actually help you create something that's not tangible yet. Because Mercury there says we can't pull it to form yet, but we can certainly imagine it. So, you know, when this Mercury sextiles Uranus on Wednesday, it's like a light bulb going off or going on. You know, is it going off or going on? Maybe both. Ding, 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 ding. So it's a time to take up a new...
No, it's going on because it's the first of three times that this transit will happen mm-hmm. because Mercury will hit Uranus again mm-hmm. In this sextile when it's retrograde and then again when it turns direct and starts moving forward again.
Right, and so, that date
The first of three, yeah, you got to pay attention to what happens because that'll give you the clue onto what the deal is about Mercury sextile Uranus.
Right, so that comes in and hits February 5th. And stays in operation through the retrograde through March 22nd. So
that's a long time.
Yeah. Well, that period is through. That's the finishing up the shadow period and some. But remember, this is the third time that hits. So mm-hmm. take up a new subject, get an astrology reading, sign up for some webinars.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, this is about learning what you don't know, and you don't know. What you don't know. It's
wild. It's a fun idea of exploration.
It's all about, and Uranus is all about being online too. So, I mean, it's a go online to find stuff out or look mm-hmm. in new places.
Yeah.
And Uranus actually wants you to try something different.
Yeah. It's actually my favorite day of February.
Oh, perfect.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
February 5.
Yeah.
So let's move on to the next transit. We have Friday, February 7th, Venus ingress into Aries.
At 2:02 p.m. I called that outgoing and social, but maybe fickle. Yeah. Venus here is in her detriment. She's magnetic. She can go after what she wants, but she can be restless. So she's, you know, like I said, happy, positive, but might be a little pushy, might be a little advancement and aggression, maybe assertion. What do you say about that, Susan?
I think Venus will be pissed because she's moving from being exalted, mm-hmm. the guest of honor in the house of Pisces, mm-hmm. to moving to being in detriment, mm-hmm. in Aries, mm-hmm. the house that Mars runs. Mars doesn't care if what Venus wants, while Neptune was like falling all over itself, giving her what she needed. Mm-hmm. You know, she clicked her finger and Neptune was like, oh yeah, I'll give you that. Mm-hmm. She moves into Aries and Mars goes, who are you? Oh no. Well, you can wait.
Yeah. Yeah, Mars needs to go first.
Yeah.
Well, she's visiting Mars's home, and Mars is like, I'm busy over here doing the things I want to do. I'll get to you when I get around to you. But here Venus is kind of like, well, what about me? Well, what about me? Well, you know, can kind of be a little bit pushy. Yeah. Be careful
there. I
think
it's a big energy shift for Venus to mm-hmm. go from top of the heap to practically the bottom of the heap, mm-hmm. all in one day.
Yeah. It's almost like she has to put her armor on and kind of protect herself and make sure she's being heard or stand up for herself. Yeah. So she's, mm-hmm. she's now in action.
And so once again, from a money perspective, that is a sudden shift mm-hmm. of energy. Mm-hmm. That's not a good one. Mm-hmm. So just generally, I would expect that the markets that day would have a rough time because Venus is adjusting to this new mm-hmm. Sign and not a favorite sign.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. And so moving on, Sunday, February 9th, we have the full moon in Leo.
At 20 degrees Leo at 1:33 a.m. And I consider this stepping up your game because it's sitting on my natal ascendant. Yeah, it's, you know, we've got the opposition here and the full moon is, you know, the sun is in Aquarius where the sun wants, you know, everybody to attend. It likes, you know, teamwork. It wants to help other people, wants to gather the friends and groups and organizations. And here sits the moon opposite that in Leo that says, hey, emotionally, I can do this myself. I'll just stand up and act. And, you know, Leo, of course, wants to have the big roar with much to do about, you know, what? So they have to work in tandem here. So it's kind of like stepping up your game. In addition, we've got that trine to Mars. So that kind of can give us more, more ways to win or more of that competitive style to let everybody play this game.
Yeah. But I think the moon takes center stage. I mean, it's a full moon.
Yeah.
The sun is giving it its light. Mm-hmm. It's reflecting it. It's got the spotlight, particularly in Leo, which loves the spotlight. Mm-hmm. This is where the moon has it. So I think the moon wins.
Well, the moon does.
That count.
Yeah, but it's I see it as the everybody, let's all kumbaya, is giving the light, you know, to shine that spotlight onto the moon. And the moon's like, oh, me? Oh, okay. But the moon has to realize that she's getting her light from the group. So I believe that there's got to be some sort of teamwork, you know, some in tandem. But certainly the moon can say, hey, what do I get when I win? Or, you know, how can I, you know, can I sit up on your shoulders and you parade me around or give me applause is good enough. But yeah, I believe that they have to work mm-hmm. together though, right? That's where.
Yeah.
So, and actually that's kind of it for the the week. That's enough going on, I guess.
It's going to be a great week. I'm excited. Susan, thank you so much for joining us and sticking around into the transits to help us kind of dissect through. I think it was really helpful for everyone to see how both you and Sandy banter and also see a different perspective on things. So if you guys are interested, we do have those upcoming astrology webinars, Chatting with the Stars. You can head to intentionbeads.com/events to sign up. Thank you again, Susan. We'll see you next time.
All right. Bye, Susan.
So let's move into talisman times.
Okay.
It's been kind of light. You finished one talisman, one very special one, Monday, January 27th.
Yes, I did. That was to heal illness. I drink from the cup of life to fulfill and satisfy my body and its workings. May this cup continue to stay full.
Yes. And I love that. I love the feeling of that abundance, of that nourishment, of that light, enveloping.
Well, yeah. I was using the moon at 9 degrees of Pisces, which is within that 27th mansion of the moon between 4 and 17 Pisces. So I grab that.
And so two talismans upcoming. You have Monday, February 3rd today to speak the truth.
This is later tonight at 7.09 p.m. to speak the truth. I involve others' ideas to discover what is true for me. I can understand the differences and speak what is true for me.
Yes. And I love that. And I also, I'm a big fan of healthy debates because, I think that if you are getting into any type of even relationship, whether it's like, an intimate relationship or an acquaintance or,
a business,
business relationship, it is so important to speak your truth and to know that there is more than just one truth. You know, you don't have to have the 100%, dominating thing that you have to respect. There are two sides.
Yeah. And it's nice to hear how together you can come to an agreement by speaking the truth, because you're going to have better expectations and better goals. Right. And you'll be able to understand each other's reasons for doing things.
Yeah. And it shows a lot more respect in that manner.
Yeah.
So the next talisman you have upcoming Thursday, February 6th, to incorporate global togetherness. Togetherness.
The affirmation is, I gather and teach others my extensive knowledge of universal wisdom. This brings comfort in new ways to the group.
Yeah, I love that. And I really do like the way that those words kind of cradle the group. And it's this this feeling of being held. Mm-hmm. I think just even when you were using those words, I was like, oh, that's just like a wonderful, wonderful place to be. And it kind of reminds me of the song, He's Got the Whole World.
Well, the moon is in Cancer here. So there is a feeling of that nurturing, protective, I've got you feeling. And it's trining to Venus in Pisces. So there's a good, nice trine here. Pisces is the ruler of the chart, and she is exalted, giving and allowing anything that she desires. So yeah, it's a nice little global togetherness. Yeah.
I love it. Yep. So let's move on and onto the horizon.
Ah, busy.
So we are, my goodness, so busy. So I will leave the Toronto Yoga Conference and the journey to Bali. You guys have been hearing about that. I will keep that in the description of this podcast, and I'm going to shorten this up just a little bit. So we have February 5th, the Dr. Laura Berman Show. And if you are interested in getting live questions with Sandy and Dr. Laura, you need to email questions@uncoveredradio.com. And you guys do such a beautiful job.
And why this one's so special is you and I will be in LA for the Conscious Life Expo that weekend. But
And they record the radio show in LA.
Right. So we're going to be going in. You'll have to get some videos of Dr. Laura Berman and I.
Oh, that's a great idea. I'll do that.
But we're, taking your birth information. Mm-hmm. Like Alex just said, you're going to need to give that, because I'll be doing your chart and Dr. Laura Berman will be giving you quantum love physics advice.
Yes, perfect. And so, like you said earlier, we're heading to Los Angeles, and this is for the Conscious Life Expo. It's happening February 7th through the 9th. And if you want more information on this event, you can head to intentionbeads.com/events. I know that this is going to be a big, big expo. They have so many vendors, so many speakers.
Oh,
it's overwhelming.
Russell Brandt, he's one of the speakers. They're right. doing a whole astrology panel.
Yeah,
like a 2-hour panel for what's coming up for 2020. Really, really big people. And we've never done this event before. We've seen it. We've looked at it. We've been invited. But it just didn't work out on our schedule. But this year it does. So we're excited to go.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So yeah, we'd love to have you guys share with your LA friends, or if there's anyone in the area or going to be in the LA area during February, we'd love to see them at this expo. It's going to be a wonderful event. So February 12th, you guys did hear before when we were talking with Susan, Chatting with the Stars astrology webinars are happening. And February 12th is going to be our first ever. We would love for you to join us. The link is in the description, of course. Mm-hmm. Also head to intentionbeads.com/events. So tell me what you're going to be talking about for this astrology webinar.
This one, February 12th, is our first one, and Mercury retrograde in Pisces. And we're really going to wrap up what Mercury retrograde is about. It does not deserve the bad rap that everyone gives it. So if you're interested in learning what it really does mean and how you can use it to its best advantage, come sign up for that, because we'll be giving dates for the entire year for all Mercury retrogrades, but this one specifically, because it'll be happening in about 5 days from this webinar. So see how it affects your chart. We have an ability for an extra $5. And by the way, these are $20.
Right.
An hour of recorded Zoom.
Yes.
And for an extra $5, I will get your natal chart to you with the bi-wheel of what we're talking about, so that you can see and kind of relay
recap
anything that you can put your notes on that, so that you can see how that's working for you. Yeah.
And then moving on, February 13th, we have the Love Yourself, Love Your Health event. That's in Elk Grove, Illinois, local to this area in Chicago. This is going to be one of their annual events, and it's only 2 hours. So this is one you can't miss. You got to hurry up, get there, and really experience the whole event in that 2 hours.
Yeah. It's the day before Valentine's Day from 5 to 7.
Right.
So right after work.
It's all about making sure that you have your first Valentine, and your first Valentine is always yourself.
Yes.
And then you get to pick who's your second Valentine. Okay. And so February 23rd, we have the Constellation Bracelet Workshop is back in action. So this is our spring equinox. This is going to be a very powerful season. And we are inviting all of you podcast listeners to learn more. Web page that I have the link to in this description is amazing, because it tells you what all you're going to be experiencing through this webinar series. And you have like 14 hours with you and Sandy.
And this is talisman making
every time you meet.
Every time we meet, I am making a talisman based on your affirmation for the energy of that day.
So you're not just getting a talisman that has one set intention. You're actually getting a talisman that has 12.
Well, a talisman that's a bracelet that has the 12 beads.
Yes. Yeah. So it's still a bracelet, but it has 12 of your intentions. And so this is more of like a whole life type of intention that you're going for. Of course, you can find more information in the link. So March 7th through the 8th, we are headed to North Lake, Illinois for the Body, Mind, Spirit Expo. You guys have heard us talk about this before. Of course, we want you to join us and explore all these wonderful vendors. And they keep having new ones pop up. And we always are so excited about that.
And I'm teaching on Saturday from 11 to 12. And I'll be teaching 101 basics.
Yes.
Of astrology.
Okay. And so moving on, we have March 14th is our Uranus webinar. We have done this once before, and this is all about Uranus moving into Taurus. And so if you've been listening to our podcast for a while, you hopefully get the idea that Taurus is that structured earth, that really, you know, dense
fixed
earth.
Yeah.
And Uranus is the wrecking ball. So only you can imagine what these two things have in common. It means big change happening, mm-hmm. demolition. What needs to be completely broken down into little,
debris.
Pebbles,
yeah.
and rebuilt from this point. So we're going to be discussing that in the Uranus webinar, and it's a talisman.
That's a talisman ceremony. This is about a 2.5-hour webinar. I get your birth information, of course, in advance, and I go through worksheets with you, dates when Uranus is hitting any of your personal planets in your chart, and what house it's going through, and the dates for that, because it will bring new sudden shock and awe to that particular field or area of your life. So be ready.
Yes. And so we do have those two events that I talked about earlier, the Toronto Yoga Conference and our Journey to Bali. It's our retreat that we take to Bali every year.
We still have a couple spaces left.
And we do. We have some spaces available.
And
so,
I just booked our pre-retreat for
yes.
anybody that wants to come a couple days before the actual retreat. So it's a beautiful Airbnb home in the middle of the mountains and a pool and the rice paddies.
And mm-hmm. breakfast cooked for us every morning. It's delicious. Mm-hmm. You get to then just, when you finally arrive somewhere, don't you really just like resting? I mean, I do. We don't normally get that privilege and that luxury, because whenever we land somewhere, we're like, we got to go. We got to set up the show. We got to, do our talks. We need to go to the radio show. And so this pre-retreat is a really wonderful way. And if you're traveling all the way to Bali, give yourself a little bit of time to rest and relax and just get to know the ins and outs in a slow and steady way.
Right. It's really about getting your land legs back. And then, of course, you can come as early as April 18th, but our retreat starts April 20th at 5:00 in the afternoon. So there's that.
Okay.
All right.
So let's move into our final little segment.
Okay,
our house.
So
welcome in, everybody, because I'm really excited. The last 2 weeks, I've had a really wonderful companion next to me, almost my little. Yes,
because there's been a companion in between us,
and her name's Keela, and she's this cute little Maltese dog. And so I figured I wanted to talk to all the dog lovers out here, and just talk to you guys about how much this little munchkin is adorable. And so we're gonna right now take a quick snapshot. So you guys are gonna be able to see this live in the description, I think. Yeah, in the description, with me and this little love muffin.
Hey, Keela.
Hi. Okay.
Okay.
So we have this. You guys are going to be able to see that in the description. So Keela is this cute little Maltese, and everywhere I bring her, so I'm dog sitting for one of my best friends, and she is adorable. Every single time I bring her, say like anywhere, she comes with this little backpack.
It's like a front pack. It's a baby pack.
Right.
But it's for dogs. And Keela can't weigh more than 10 pounds, like.
No, I mean, like, maybe not
seven?
Even more than 5. I mean,
I don't know. We should put her on the little, okay. on the little food
maybe
scale.
Maybe 5.
Like
I just picked her up a little bit. Okay, maybe 5.
But people think she's a brand new puppy and she's 10 years old.
She's 10 years old. So share this mind-blown moment with me and check out this picture, because this little cutie is 10 years old. That's 70 in dog years.
But don't you think the dog would be old enough to know what these pee pads are?
Oh, well, when you take an animal out of its natural habitat, there's this like unknowing, this confusion of what to do. So let me explain this whole story.
Close. But no cigar.
Right. So she has these little pee pads because she's so tiny, and the Chicago winters, you all can
There's
imagine
no
how brutal they are. And so for a little 5-pound dog, she can barely, she like gets, and she's white too. So she like, you just drop her in the snow, you're not going to find her. So, so basically she has these little pee pads that she will, you know, go to the potty on. And when she's over at your house, yeah, when you're watching her,
she misses it. She's like,
she thinks all your rugs are the pee pads.
She needs some putting lessons or something.
Putting lessons?
I don't know. Get it in the area. Like
potty lessons?
Well, I was thinking of golf, like getting it in the hole.
Oh, okay. That was out there.
Yeah, but it's been really nice to have this little doggy who I do love.
Yeah.
But, you know, dogs are, you know, they're a lot of work.
She's a little responsibility. But she honestly, I mean, we've done a couple webinars. We've done two podcasts already. And nobody knows
she's here. Only because...
Except we're talking about her now and she's moving my microphone around.
Yeah, well, she's trying to get across the table.
She's trying to jump on the table. So,
man, the other night you went out to a concert and I watched Keela, you know, all by myself. And she, I have never heard this noise. I didn't know what it was. I thought somebody had broke into my basement or into my first level because I was up on the second level, and thinking that somebody had broken my house, that you maybe didn't put the garage door down or something. And I was about ready to head upstairs on the rooftop deck.
to run away from the strange sound.
In the winter, up on the rooftop deck and then get stuck out there. When it only was the dog crying for you.
Aww.
But we shouldn't hope Ashley doesn't listen to this podcast. And
no, she's heard it before. She has a very loud and, yeah, it's a little creepy. She's got a creepy little cry, but she does not stop. So she's so attached to, you know, her owner or her little dog sitter that she will just cry and cry and cry until they come back. So, Sandy, yeah, I know you had to.
And then we have that beautiful clock downstairs that's the singing bowl, and it would go off every hour on the hour, and she thinks you're coming home. So then another rappy, lappy, crappy. No, it's like,
okay.
It's horrible.
Oh, no.
It's so scary. I was like, seriously, I thought somebody had broken it. It's not what you just did. That's minor compared to walk out and let's not be mean. But
so anyway, she is a cute little therapy dog, and I've really enjoyed having her around. She really just, all she does is sleep all day and just be cute, and she wears these little coats. And so anyway, shout out to all of the dog lovers.
Owners and lovers. And,
yeah. Out there.
I got a little treat of a dog.
Yes.
Yeah. So, it was fun.
So yeah, thanks for coming into our house. And we and Keela bid you adieu until next week.
Watch where you step.
And we will talk to you next week. We'll see you on Monday.
See you on Monday. Have a great weekend, everybody.